Hey guys, Rebecca here for another video. It is nearly travel season for many of us, so I wanted to tell y'all about a new app that I have been using for a few months. Apparently this app has been out for a while, but I had not heard of it till recently, and I wanted to use it for a few months before I made a video about it just to make sure it was legit and to see what all of the pros and the cons to using this app are. So the app is called Get Upside, and if you are at all familiar with Ibotta, it works very similarly to that, except it's for gas for your car. What you do is, say for example, you live in the Tampa area of Florida, you would open up the app. It will show you gas stations around you and also show you what rebate they are offering. It's 5 cents a gallon, 8 cents a gallon, 12 cents a gallon sometimes. And what you do is figure out which gas station you would like to go to, click on it, and then you claim this gas station and claim the rebate. And you have 4 hours from the time that you claim the rebate to submit a receipt with all of the appropriate information showing that you did in fact fill up at that gas station. So it's super easy to use, very user-friendly. And to keep this video short, I will quickly go over the largest pros and cons to this app. So the pros, obviously, is that you're getting money back on something that you're going to buy anyway, unless you have a Tesla, which I do not yet have a Tesla, maybe one day. So for the time being, I am still getting gas and I might as well get some cash back on it, right? The cons are you will not find really cheap gas stations in this app. For example, we have a local grocery store called Ingles. They're kind of known for having really cheap gas around here. And they won't show up in the app, but my husband, who is very much a car guy and has been working on cars his entire life, will tell you firsthand that if you're interested in longevity for your vehicle, you really should not use cheap gas. Only put in top tier gas in your vehicle. And guys, him and his dad, they've got the Honda to prove it, if you know what I mean. They bought a brand new Honda Civic in 1988. That car had nearly 375,000 miles on it before it finally bit the dust. They bought it new, they never put cheap gas in it, and they took care of it. So yeah, it's beneficial to get the top tier gas, and thankfully this Get Upside app has a lot of the top tier gas stations on it. Now, for the biggest two cons. First of all, you do have to remember to look at this app before you go and get the gas. If you go and fill up and then you're like, oh man, I forgot to look at the app and check and see if I had a rebate, it's too late. But the biggest con to this app, I found out after using it the first time. I typically will fill up at Shell gas stations, and I have a loyalty card for Shell. I'm a loyalty member. I put in my number at the pump and it will give me a discount on the gas price at the pump, and then I fill up. So with Get Upside, you're not allowed to double dip like this. So anything that you do that is going to give you a discount at the pump before you put the gas in the car, it's not going to work for you. What I do to combat this, I know that with my loyalty program that I have with Shell, I get 5 cents off at the pump. And before I get gas for my car, I will open up the app and I'll look and see what discount Get Upside is offering. If it's 5 cents or less, then I'll just use my loyalty card member. If it's more than 5 cents, then I'll use the Get Upside app for that discount. And in case you're wondering, you are still able to use a cashback credit card if you choose to do that and get discounts on your gas that way. That will not give you a discount at the pump, so it works. I use a cashback credit card whenever I get gas. That way I can get 3% back. So every time I fill up, y'all, I am at least getting 3% back, plus either a loyalty discount from Shell or a discount from GetUpside. So that is the biggest negative to the app, which apparently when it first came out, you used to be able to double dip like that, but you can't anymore. They kind of got privy to that. And another thing that's not really a con, but just something to be mindful of for this app. When you submit a receipt, it will have a list of items that it needs to have on that receipt. Just double check yourself and make sure that everything is listed on that sheet. They want to see the price per gallons, the number of gallons that you bought. They want to see the address of the location that you got your gas to make sure that you did in fact go to the right gas station. And you've got to have the date and time on there, obviously. So make sure that all of that is on your receipt before you submit it in the app. I did actually run into a situation where I went to a BP station to fill up. I printed my receipt at the pump and it had all of the information on there except for the address of the gas station. So I had to actually physically walk in the gas station and get a duplicate receipt printed. Not that big of a deal. It just took an extra 30 seconds of effort to do that. Overall, I really enjoy this app. If you have a long commute like I do, it's definitely beneficial. If you are not driving a fuel efficient vehicle like my husband, he has a big truck, ain't gonna lie, then this is a good app to use. In the past few months that I've been using it, I've saved over $15, and I recently cashed that out to my PayPal account. I had no trouble doing that. They did not take any cut. I just cashed it to my PayPal account, and then I transferred it to my bank. Easy peasy. So you might be asking yourself, why go through all of this hassle just to save a few cents on gas, right? Well, y'all, if you are in the financial independence retire early community like myself, you will know that a penny saved is more than a penny earned, guys. Let's just say, for example, that you save 20 bucks every couple of months using this GetUpside app. Well, that's about 10 bucks a month. So if you're able to save that by the end of the year, you'd have $120. If you saved that $120 over 10 years, well, then you would have $1,200, right? But if you instead saved that money and you decided to invest it in a low-cost broad-based index fund and got just average returns, that $1,200 over 10 years instead turns into almost $1,900. So guys, it all counts. That's an extra $700 just from saving a few pennies on gas on your week-to-week purchases. It all counts. So for that reason, I definitely am going to continue to use this app. That's why I decided to make this video. And I do have a referral link for you down below if you would like to check them out. If you use the link, then you'll get an extra 20 cents off your first receipt, and I'll also get a 20 cent bonus for the referral. It's a win-win. I hope you'll use the link and check out the app if you've not heard of them before. If you're new to my channel and you found this video helpful, then give it a like and don't forget to subscribe. I will see y'all in my next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.